We'll do an example of a two-point Gaussian quadrature rule. So the example problem statement is estimate this particular integral. By a two-point Gaussian quadrature rule. So let's look at the solution for this particular problem. We already know that if we have an integral going from a to b f of x dx, a definite integral, that is approximated by our two-point Gaussian quadrature rule by c1 times f of x1 plus c2 times f of x2, where these values of c1, x1, c2, x2 are given in terms of a and b. So for c1 it is b minus a divided by 2, for c2 it is b minus a divided by 2, for x1 it is b minus a divided by 2 times minus 1 divided by square root of 3 plus b plus a divided by 2. And then x2 is b minus a divided by 2 times 1 divided by square root of 3 plus b plus a divided by 2. So if that is the case, then all we have to do is to calculate these two weighting coefficients, c1 and c2, and these two arguments of the function x1 and x2 based on the values of a and b, which are the lower and upper limits of integration. Okay. So for our case, f of x is 5x e to the power minus 2x, because that is the integrand here. A is 0.1, that is the lower limit here. B is 1.3, which is the upper limit here. So based on that, let's go and calculate value of c1, c2, x1, and x2 for the formula. C1 is b minus a divided by 2, which is 1.3 minus 0.1 divided by 2, which is 0.6. C2 is b minus a divided by 2, and that's 1.3 minus 0.1 divided by 2, which is also 0.6. X1 is b minus a divided by 2 times minus 1 divided by square root of 3 plus b plus a divided by 2. So we substitute the values of a and b, 1.3 minus 0.1 divided by 2 times minus 1 divided by square root of 3 plus 1.3 plus 0.1 divided by 2. So once we have that, that number turns out to be equal to 0.35359. So that's the value of x1. For the value of x2, we do the same thing. X2 is b minus a divided by 2 times 1 divided by square root of 3 plus b plus a divided by 2. The only difference being here is minus 1 divided by square root of 3 for x1, and here it is plus 1 divided by square root of 3 for x2. So 1.3 minus 0.1 divided by 2 times 1 divided by square root of 3 plus 1.3 plus 0.1 divided by 2. And this number here turns out to be 1.0464. So now we have the values of c1, c2, x1, x2. All we have to do is to put them back in the formula and we'll be able to get the estimate of our integral. So let's go and calculate the value of the function x1. In this case, our value of x1, which we just calculated, is 35359. And that gives us 5x, which is 0.35359, times e to the power minus 2 times x1, which is 0.35359. And this number here turns out to be 0.87165. Similarly, we want to calculate the value of the function x2, and the value of x2 we just calculated is 1.0464. So that turns out to be 5 times 1.0464 times e to the power minus 2 times 1.0464. And that number here turns out to be equal to 0.64532. So now we have all the ingredients for estimating the value of this integral by using the two-point Gaussian quadrature rule. So we have integral of 0.1 to 1.3 f of x dx. F of x in our case is 5x e to the power minus 2x. That's the integrand which we use to calculate the value of the function x1 and x2. And that will be equal to c1 times f of x1 plus c2 times f of x2. C1 is 0.6. This is the value of the function at 0.35359 plus 0.6, the value of the function at 1.0464. We just calculated the value of the function at 0.35359, which is 0.87165. And this one here is 0.64532. And this number here turns out to be, this should be approximately here. And this number turns out to be equal to 0.91018. So that is the estimate of our integral by using the two-point Gaussian quadrature rule. Let's go and see how much relative true error this number has with respect to the true value. So let's calculate the relative true error. So relative true error is defined as true value minus approximate value divided by true value. And if we calculate in terms of percentage, we'll be multiplying by 100. So the absolute relative true error will be the true value, which is given to us as 0.89387. You can do that as homework if you don't know how to do that. Minus 0.91018, that's the value which we got by using the two-point Gaussian quadrature rule, divided by the exact value 0.89387. Want to calculate as a percentage, multiply by 100, and we'll get that to be 1.8247%. So that's the amount of relative true error which we get by using the two-point Gaussian quadrature rule on this integral right here. And that's the end of this segment.